Good morning, students. Welcome to this session. In this session, we'll be studying about the Ripper algorithm. So, this Ripper algorithm is an algorithm which helps in deriving the rules directly. In our previous sessions, we had studied sequential covering algorithm, which helps in deriving the rules directly from the given training set. And we also have seen various evaluation measures and rule growing strategy. So here we have one more algorithm, that is Ripper algorithm, which is again an algorithm which helps in deriving the rules directly from the training set. So this Ripper algorithm is a widely used rule induction algorithm. So the expansion of Ripper is repeated incremental pruning to produce error reduction. So this is what the Ripper means. This algorithm is used for two purposes. So first, it is used for building models from the data sets with the imbalanced class distribution. So here, it is important for us to understand what is this imbalanced class distribution. So it means that in a data set, when we have several records, out of which maximum of the records belongs to one particular class and minimum of the records belongs to several other classes. So suppose consider the training set has 100 records, in which 80 records belongs to class A, whereas another 20 records belongs to class B or C or D and so on. So such data set or the training set wherein the distribution will be of this kind is said to be imbalanced class distribution. So when you are building a classification model for such imbalanced data set, we can go for Ripper algorithm. Next, this Ripper algorithm works well with noisy data sets as it uses validation set to prevent the model overfitting. So here in this case, we need to understand two words. One is what is validation set and what is model overfitting. So far, we had learnt about a training set, right? So these are the set of records which are used for training the model. When I say training set, so the set of records which is used for training the model. So what is this validation set? So validation set is a separate set of records taken from the training set to measure the performance of the new training records. So when you want to measure the performance, so from the training set or the records in the training set, what we have, we take out few records and make it as the validation set. So this validation set, it is sometimes also referred to as, or in some textbook or some authors call this validation set to be as a test set as well. So I can tell that among the records in the training set, what we have, 2/3 of the records in the training set will be used for training the model, whereas 1/3 of it will be used for validation. So that 1/3 record or in the training set will be now referred to as the validation set. So validation set is nothing but set of records from the training set which is used for validation purpose, validating the model or to enhance the or identify the performance of the model. Now coming to model overfitting. So this is a situation wherein the model performs very well on the given training example, but it fails to perform on the test example. So what is this means is, if I want to keep it more simpler, consider the situation of a student where a student performs generally well in the internals and scores well, But when it comes to exams, he will fail to score maximum amount. So that is what, that situation we can consider be as a model overfitting. That is, in the internals, his performance is good, but actually in the exam where he has to perform well, his performance is poor when compared to the performance in the internals. So such situations with respect to the classification, wherein the model is performing well with respect to the training records that we have, but it fails to perform well with the test examples. So such situation, we can consider it to be as a model overfitting. So Ripper algorithm overcomes this model overfitting problem by using the validation set. So for these two purposes, we can make use of Ripper algorithm to identify or to derive the rule set directly from the data set given. So now let us see how exactly the Ripper algorithm works. So what is, how are we going to apply Ripper algorithm on a given set of data? So here I'm going to consider two different cases. Case one is that training record has only two classes. We have given with the training record, and the training record has only two class. In such case, what, how does the Ripper work? So in such case, what Ripper does is, among the records given, it identifies the majority class, or identifies which class is appears maximum number of times in the given training set, and takes this majority class as a default class. Say consider you have 50 records in the training set, and you have class yes and class no. Among the 50 records, say 40 records belongs to class yes and 10 records belongs to class no. In such case, what Ripper does is, it takes class yes to be as the default class. We also have learned about this default class. What is the use of this default class with respect to the property of the rule set, if you remember? That is with respect to the mutual exclusive and the exhaustiveness. While talking those two property with respect to a rule set, we had talked about default class, right? So here what Ripper does is, which class is repeated, whose frequency is more, it will consider that class to be as the default class. And then for the remaining records, that is out of 40, out of 50, 10 records that belongs to class no, for that what it does is, it tries to derive various rule. Okay, so that is how Ripper works with respect to training record which has only two class. Now suppose consider training record has multiple class. So in that case, how Ripper is going to work, which is case two. Okay, so here what we do is, we first consider all the class that is available and then arrange them in on the basis of its frequency in a particular order. Say consider I'm going to arrange it in the increasing order. So in case of training records which has multiple class, Ripper, what it does first is, it arranges class based on its frequency, and it will be in the increasing order of the frequency. Say let's say I have a class as y1, y2 up to yc, and here what I can tell is, as I told, say this is the order in which it is arranged. Now as I told, it is arranged in the increasing order of the frequency. So y1 will be the least frequent one and yc will be the most frequent one. And as I told earlier, which class is having maximum frequency, that would be considered to be as a default class. As in this case, yc will be considered to be as the default class. Now, so in the first instance, what Ripper does is, it tries to derive rules for those records which belongs to class y1. And in this case, how is it going to derive the rule is, it is going to apply sequential covering algorithm to derive the rule, which means those records which belongs to y1 will be considered as positive example and all other classes will be considered to be as the negative example, right? So that is how the sequential algorithm works, correct? Now, at this particular junction, what Ripper does is, when the sequential covering algorithm is trying to derive rules for Y1 as considering it to be as a positive class, at the same junction, Ripper, it extract rules for Y2, distinguishing it from the other class. So Ripper tries to derive rules for Y2 by distinguishing it from the other class. And this will be repeated. This will be repeated until a stopping criteria is met. So as I told earlier, you will have YC being considered to be as the default class as well. Okay, so Ripper algorithm always considers minority class first to derive the rules, and then it moves towards the majority class. So now let us consider how rule growing is done with respect to Ripper. So Ripper makes use of general to specific strategy of growing rules. So what is this general to specific strategy, which we have studied earlier? So we begin with the generalized rule. So that is the rule which tries to cover all the records in the training set. And then we keep on adding conjuncts to it, correct? So the same method is used by Ripper also. So in this process, for evaluation of the conjunct, among the several metrics that we have studied earlier, which includes likelihood ratio, Laplace, M estimate, and Foyle's information gain, Ripper makes use of Foyle's information gain for evaluation of conjuncts. When we have the rule growing strategy being decided, and also evaluation technique or evaluation metric is being decided, now what we need to have is, we need to have a stopping criteria. So what is the stopping criteria here is, so the addition of conjuncts will be stopped when the rule starts to cover the negative examples. So I'll keep on adding with the generalized rule. For the generalized rule, I'll keep on adding the conjuncts. And while adding the conjunct, I'll see to that it the evaluation is done using Foyle's information gain. So when am I going to stop adding the conjuncts? When the rule is going to cover the negative example. As the next step, based on its performance on the validation set, we start rule pruning. So what is rule pruning? So how it is done with respect to Ripper, we'll see. So here, with respect to rule pruning, to identify whether a particular rule to be pruned or not, we use a metric. And the metric that is used here is this. P minus N divided by P plus N. So what is this P and what is N? P is nothing but number of positive examples covered, and N is nothing but number of negative examples covered. So this metric here, it is somewhere related to the rule accuracy with respect to the validation set. Now, how am I going to prune the rule? So whenever I add a conjunct, whenever a conjunct is added or whenever a conjunct is removed, I'll identify the value of this particular metric. So I will identify this value of this metric for the original rule and the value of this metric for the new rule. If the value of this for the new rule is better than the original rule, then I'll retain that conjunct, whether it is added or removed. If it is removed, I'll retain that new rule. If it is added, again, I'll retain that new rule. If not, what we'll do is, we will not consider that particular conjunct which is newly added. Now, since we are starting it from the generalized rule, once the rule set is generated, we will have several rules present in the rule set. So with respect to pruning, what I'll be doing is, I'll removing the conjuncts to check whether the new rule belongs to that particular rule set or not. So how am I going to remove the rules? So that we'll see, how are we going to remove the rules? So let us consider that I have a rule like this. I have a rule wherein I have four conjuncts. A is one conjunct, B is the other conjunct, C and D are the other two conjuncts. So there are four conjuncts present in this particular rule, which yields or which covers this particular class called as Y. Now, with respect to rule pruning in Ripper, it always tries to remove the conjunct at the rightmost end. So in the rule, which is the conjunct at the rightmost end, first that will be removed, which means in this case, I'll remove D. I'll remove D, and for the new rule, which is nothing but which includes the conjunct A, B, C, I'll find the metric, I'll calculate the value of the metric P minus N divided by P plus N. So after removing this D, if the rule's quality is improved via that particular metric, then I'll consider that rule which will not have conjunct D. Okay, suppose consider after removing D, the quality is not improved. In such case, what I do is, as the next step, I will consider to remove both C and D. I'll consider to remove both C and D. And then again, I'll identify the quality using the metric defined for the rule which contains the conjunct only A and B. And then if required in the next step, I'll be removing B, C, D, and then identify the quality. So that is how it will be done. So always with respect to rule pruning, we will be removing the conjunct from the rightmost end. So that is how the Ripper works. Okay, so this is with respect to rule pruning using Ripper. Now, next we will consider building rule set using Ripper. So how are we going to build the rule set? After generating a rule, since Ripper uses a sequential covering algorithm, we know with respect to sequential covering, once a particular rule is identified or once a particular rule is derived, we have to eliminate all positive and negative examples. The same thing that we do here. Okay. So now this rule will be added to the rule set. So till when, like this, we'll be repeating or we'll be identifying the new rules and adding it to the rule set until a particular stopping condition is met. Or until it does not violate the stopping condition, I'll be adding the rules into the rule set. So here, apart from the usual stopping condition or stopping criteria that we consider, we can also consider two more stopping criteria. One is total description length. So what is this total description length is? For every rule set, we will have a minimum description length. Say let it be D. Let D be the minimum description length for a particular rule set. So what I'll do now is, I'll identify the possible rules and keep on adding to the rule set until this D is not reached. Once the D is reached, what is D here? That is the minimum description length, minimum total description length of the rule set. I have considered it to be as D. So until that is not crossed, we will be adding the rules into the rule set. Once if D is crossed by adding a particular rule, then we will stop adding rules to the rule set. So that is the another stopping criteria, which is total description length. We have one more, which is nothing but error rate. So what here we do is, we will consider a rule, we'll identify the rule and calculate its error rate with respect to validation set. If the error rate here is nothing but misclassification or classification being wrongly done, that is what is error rate. Okay, so if the error rate is less than 50%, then I will add the rule to the rule set. If the error rate of a particular rule is more than 50% with respect to the validation set, I will not be adding that particular rule into the rule set. So this is the procedure for building the rule set using the RIPPER. So with this, we'll come to the end of the working of RIPPER. So to summarize it, what we have done in case with respect to RIPPER algorithm is, so RIPPER algorithm is nothing but, it uses a strategy wherein first we will apply sequential covering, and then with respect along with the sequential covering we'll also apply RIPPER, which starts covering the minority class first and then moves towards the majority class. Also the majority class will be considered to be as the default class, and then we have a evaluation technique considered, which is nothing but false information gain, right? Stopping criteria is also considered. So based on all this, rule set will be built and new rules will be identified. So this is working of RIPPER algorithm. So with this, we have completed with the direct method of rule extraction with respect to rule based classifier. One is sequential covering algorithm, this other one is RIPPER algorithm. Both are very important. You may get problems with respect to sequential covering and a theoretical question based on RIPPER algorithm in examination.
Thank you, students. If you have any doubts or queries or for feedback, you can write back to me. Thank you.